Start in the Free State today, where the Bongani Hospital in Welkom is currently grappling with multiple crises. Now, they emanate from staff shortages, poor maintenance, as well as ill-equipped theatres. Now, the DA conducted a visit to the facility as part of its Hospital Health Check campaign.
First hospital in Lijelibuzwa district. It treats about 2,500 outpatients a month. It's currently without a surgeon, and that has left patients like 48-year-old Kefas Mangani stranded. He sustained injuries that need to be operated on.
I fell and broke my pelvis, and I've been waiting to be operated for 1 month and 3 weeks. I couldn't get my May grant, and now there's a possibility that I won't get the June grant either.
The situation in the rest of the hospital is just as bad. Only 3 of the 9 theatres are operational.
Last year, they bought about the theatre beds, because you must remember, each and every theatre, different types of operation, they use different types of bed. The beds, really, they were acquired. When they arrived, they couldn't even, as the people that they were given the tender, they couldn't even assemble the beds themselves. There were a guy from China that was also here. The guy, because of communication, he fails even to help them. So as a result, they have to pack those beds and go back.
A newly acquired air conditioning system has left the hospital freezing cold. And there is trouble in the renal unit.
What is shocking, that renal unit, it has never been operational at all. Until now, they are using the mobile OR machines to purify the water. If that renal plant was in use, they could at least dialyze about 24 patients per day. But now, because of the small mobile units, they are only mobilizing about 10 to 9 patients per day. It's a crisis.
The hospital management hopes to appoint new doctors soon. 9 doctors have not been paid their 2 month salaries.
All those submissions for 8 medical officers, they are at Treasury. So from the Treasury, I will be getting the submission. So I'll be able to appoint those medical officers, plus the surgeon, plus the other for internal medicine, the consultant for internal medicine.
Noche says for now, they are also referring patients to other hospitals for operations. Palesa Moeti, SABC News, Welkom.
All right, well, our reporter Palesa Moeti is in the area and joins us now for a live update. Palesa, a very good afternoon to you. We've heard allegations that staff is saying that the theatres are in a shocking conditions, the working hours and everything. It's a terrible working environment at the Bongani Hospital. Maybe just highlight what are some of the biggest issues and grievances that have been brought forward by the staff there.
Well, the biggest issue that we found today was actually the shortage of doctors as well as nurses at Bongani Hospital. But obviously, that's not just unique to Bongani Hospital. When it comes to the shortage of medical professionals, it's a countrywide problem. But also, there was an interesting story that we also heard about theatre beds that have been found there, or rather that have been bought by the hospital from China, and nobody can assemble these beds. Now, these beds have had to be packed and sent back, because even the technician from China where they sourced these beds from couldn't put them together. But joining us right now is the head of the Department of Health, Dr. David Mutau, who's just going to take us through what we found today at Bongani Hospital. Dr. Mutau, let's start with the issue of the beds. These beds that were sourced from China, now nobody can assemble them. It's a wasted expenditure, obviously. How did that happen?
Thank you very much for the opportunity, Palesa. The fact of the matter is, it is not true that it is a wasteful expenditure, because a contract was arranged through our supply chain, processes were followed, there were specifications, and the company was appointed, beds were bought, and then there were complaints. But now, in as far as the contract is concerned, there has to be recourse. If what they have supplied is not what we are expecting, or there are problems. Obviously, there's issues of warranty that needs to kick in. There's issues of the contractor having to take those beds if they are not meeting the specification, and make sure that they replace them with immediate effect. So it is not true that it's a fruitless and wasteful expenditure.
Now let's talk about the issue of the shortage of doctors and nurses. I know that the Free State has been trying to send students, young people, to universities for these areas where there's scarce skills. How are you trying to remedy the situation with the shortage of doctors and nurses?
Look, the shortage of nurses and doctors, it's a general problem across South Africa. That is a fact. That is why a decision was taken a long time ago to send students to Cuba to go and study medicine, so that when they come back, they can then come and alleviate the problems that we have. However, there are still shortages, and the province has embarked on a project where students were sent outside the country to make sure that they study medicine and come back. Now, we also are addressing this problem by making sure that where there are vacancies, we fill those posts. But I was saying to somebody the other day that if you can give me doctors, specialists that I can appoint, I have posts I will appoint. And there was a story at some point where somebody was saying there's about 20 doctors that are unemployed. And I said, bring them on, let's appoint them. And up till today, we're still waiting for those doctors. Now, you must realize one thing, that even our universities cannot take, in terms of intake of medical students, for instance, the University of the Free State here has got only 120 spaces. Now, if you look at how many students that would pass matric with you know, your level sevens, it's a lot of them. And most of them wants to do medicine. But in terms of them getting into those universities, they are unable to do so. So the shortage, it's a historical thing. It's something that is going to be addressed over a number of years. It's not going to be addressed now. Right now, I was called here for an emergency where nurses had down tools in maternity that they are short-staffed. And we went, we talked to them. They understood that these are issues that are historical, but we're addressing them. And as I'm speaking to you now, those nurses are back at work because they understood all the issues. Now, the problem where I think, as a department, we found ourselves wanting is when we are unable to communicate properly to these people that we say are our employees. We don't communicate properly, but we are going to fix that. We are going to make sure that there's communication constantly to and fro, so that all the small issues are being resolved.
And Dr. Montau, here's another issue. The Eastern Free State is where the NHI rollout is being piloted. How is that progressing?
That has progressed quite well. It was a pilot, as you are saying, but we've decided now in the province that we're going to roll that out to other districts. But in as far as Thabong-Futsanyan, where this was piloted, things went well in terms of contracting of GPs, in terms of making sure that you know, our clinics meet the standards of ideal clinics. Although, yes, there's still a challenge in terms of infrastructure, and I can only assume that you're going to ask me that question next as to what about our infrastructure. It is a general problem in our province, and just like any other province out there, where we find ourselves with an infrastructure that is aging, that we need to pump more money to make sure that we put that bring that infrastructure up to scratch with what is expected of us. Now, if you look at health, the major challenges in as far as health is concerned is the issue of infrastructure, that's number one, is the issue of HR, number two, is your supply chain management, where contracts are being concluded, sometimes concluded by people who do not have the necessary requisite skills to do that. Hence, it predisposes us to irregular expenditure, and we are dealing with that. We are skilling people and making sure that we have people requisite for those skills, because that's a critical area. If you talk about shortage of medicine, it stems from supply chain processes which may have not happened properly, or there may have been problems in as far as that process is concerned. So those are the issues, but also availability of medicines and supplies and your ICT, it's other problems that we need to be resolving. And if you look at the WHO building blocks, it's those four issues that I've mentioned to you. You go to any province, you realize that these things are bedeviling health provision in all these provinces, and therefore we will have problems unless we address those things.
Now, Dr. Mutau, while we're at Bongani Hospital, obviously with the DA, Shadow Minister of Health, the general view there is that the government has got money to provide whatever the health department needs, you know, whether it's equipment, whether it's whatever, you know, but there's a lack of political will. I don't know if you can respond to that.
I don't know where that comes from. It can never be true that there's a lack of political will. Look, as health, we get appropriated our own budget that we need to deal with in terms of making sure that service delivery out there is taken care of. So the fact that people are saying there's lack of political will, I honestly don't understand that. Somebody should have said the unwillingness of the people that are tasked with those responsibilities is the problem. And that is the problem that we need to confront head on and deal with. The fact that somebody would not have appointed when they were supposed to appoint, it's a problem. That's an HR problem. The fact that somebody would have not timeously procured what they were supposed to have procured, it's a problem. So those are the things that we need to deal with. But in terms of political willingness, I think I can state a lot of things that has happened in this province and anywhere else where the...
Unfortunately, Dr. Muta, we'll just have to cut it there. Thank you very much for your time. That is the head of the Department of Health here in the Free State, Dr. David Muta. Just being very realistic, of course, saying that there are serious challenges in the Department of Health, which they are trying to deal with, you know, ranging from procurement processes to staff shortages. But with that, it's back to you in the studio.
Thank you so much. Palesa Moeti, our reporter, then we did hear, of course, the HOD, Dr. David Madao, saying that it's not a lack of political will to fix those issues. Maybe the people should be looking at those that are tasked with fixing the problems that might not be doing what they are expected to do. Well,